I was today years old when I realized the average man produces about 1,500 sperm every second. Bread that can accidentally get you drunk, stomach acid that dissolves razor blades, and whatever you do, don't go belly button diving. Today, we're breaking down the most medically bizarre, oddly fascinating, and downright disgusting truths about your body you probably never learned in school. All right, let's dive right in. I was today years old when I learned what autoimmune syndrome was. Yes, it's actually a real medical diagnosis. You have a brewery basically in your stomach. You will ferment carbohydrates. So if you eat pasta, bread, rice, you will actually ferment it, turn it into alcohol. Alcohol will get into your bloodstream and you will actually be intoxicated without having a sip of any alcohol like beer. And usually what ends up happening, it is from an overgrowth of yeast. And so, you know, you're going along, driving on the road, you had a sandwich for lunch and you get pulled over for drunk driving without ever having a sip of beer. I was today years old when I found out breastfeeding expends the same amount of calories as walking 7 miles. Nursing all day long typically burns about 500 calories. All the machinery, everything that's going on in the mother's body to produce the milk expends so much energy as if you ended up walking 7 miles, and that's daily. So that's really important for mothers out there who are breastfeeding to realize you gotta kind of balance that with your diet and your activities to make sure that you are getting enough calories in your body to continue to expend that energy. I was today years old when I found out tetanus got people looking like they are in Cirque du Soleil, all bendy and whatnot. Yes, so tetanus, caused by bacteria called Clostridium tetani, basically causes your body to spasm, mess with your nerves. We don't see it that often because of the vaccination programs, but yes, you would see in old textbooks and images where people's bodies were literally bent backwards because of muscle spasming. They'd have what's called the classic lockjaw or trismus, where they couldn't open their jaws. And so you have difficulty swallowing, movements, and people would end up in the hospital and they would even die because they would crush their lungs, they wouldn't be able to breathe, and there was no treatment. I was today years old when I found out cats have healing powers. I know this one sounds fake, but they purr at a certain frequency between 25 and 150, which is actually studied that they've shown to help heal bones and tissues and help regenerate them. So really cool. And aside from that, cats in general produce a low stress environment, especially with petting them, as long as you don't have an allergy to them. And I wanna know, if you have a cat, let me know in the comments. I was today years old when I realized the average man produces about 1,500 sperm every second. The testes produce a ton of sperm every single day. Testes make 500,000,000,000 sperm in somebody's lifetime. That is a massive number. Is it because we make that many babies? No, it's just a very, very small, tiny fraction of the sperm make it to fertilization. I was today years old when I discovered your stomach acid can dissolve razor blades. Not that you should test it. So yes, hydrochloric acid in the stomach has a pH anywhere between like 1.5 to 3. So super acidic. So at that level, strong enough to corrode metal. Maybe it's strong enough to break down a razor blade. I'm not talking like a box cutting razor blade. We're talking about the small little razor blades that people use to shave. And why do I say this? Because people do come into the emergency department often. A lot of prisoners or people in jail after swallowing metal objects. But it's typically not going to sit in your stomach long enough for the acids to actually corrode it and break it down. I was today years old when I discovered hiccups are basically a leftover reflex from when we were fish. Come on.
Come on!
Hiccups are a spasm of your diaphragm that then leads to your vocal cords closing for a second, making the funny noise. And so they hypothesize that it's a remnant of basically amphibian type of maneuvers where water is passing through the gills. Sometimes it can be to swallowing air, weird food, hot and cold getting into our stomach. There's a lot of different reasons that are really weird and quirky, but nobody exactly prickly nose. My go-to trick of trying to get the hiccups to stop: your own fingers in your ears, you tilt your head back and have somebody pour you some water. You continuously swallow the water, maybe for a good like 10 seconds or so, and the hiccups should be gone. I was today years old when I learned the hard way that laughing too hard can actually trigger a fainting spell, something called laughter syncope. Syncope is a fancy medical word that we use for passing out. And majority of the time, passing out has to do with decreased volume in our bodies or decreased blood flow to our brain. And in this case, when you're laughing, you increase intrathoracic pressure. So a lot more pressure in your chest, and that decreases blood flow in and out. So while you have so much laughter and you're having a good time, you're not getting blood flowing going to your brain. And for that few seconds that there's lack or minimal amount of blood flow, your body's like, nope, shrunk, and you pass out. I was today years old when I found out your belly button has bacteria not found anywhere else in the world. How gross is that? Yes. Studies of belly button swabs have shown that they're very vast, unique microbiome down there. Everybody has a unique belly button, AKA navel microbiome. Interestingly enough, that amazing microbiome really doesn't do anything. It's made up of bacteria that's on our skin. It sits there for a while and makes its new friends too, maybe morphs into other bacteria and micropathogens. And why? It's a great petri dish. It's just this dark, moist area that probably doesn't get clean as often as one would want to. So please make sure you do. I was today years old when I experienced my first hangover. Kill me now. Oh my gosh. But hangovers are a perfect storm of dehydration, low blood sugar, inflammation, and a buildup of a toxin called acetaldehyde. So you're getting a headache, that pounding headache, dilated blood vessels, nausea, irritation to your stomach lining, all bad things after a fun night of going out. There's no cure except time and rehydration. If you do plan on going out and you want to try something that might help prevent or reduce a hangover, definitely check out a product that I helped formulate. It's called Poor Decisions by my company, Life Happens. If you want to have a good night and not a bad morning, definitely check out lifehappens.com or Amazon for Poor Decisions. I was today years old when I found out that losing your pinky toe messes up your balance way more than losing your big toe. Surprisingly true. Yes, super important. It stabilizes us, keeps us from falling over. The big toe has to do with power and pushing off and a little bit of stabilization, but the pinky, that one that's just sitting way out there, helps us balance. So if you lose that toe, your stability and your gait's gonna be way off. So if you had to lose any toes, you wanna lose the middle ones. I was today years old when I realized we technically glow in the dark, just too dim for our eyes to see. Yes, it's actually quite amazing, and we do glow in the dark, and that's because of something called biophoton emission. Our bodies and the metabolic processes that are going on emit a very dim glow, but the problem is it's about 1,000 times too dim for our eyes to pick it up. And interestingly enough, you'd ask the question of like, can animals see it? No, they can't as well. But we have cameras, specialized cameras, that can actually pick it up and see the glow of our bodies. I was today years old when I realized your tongue can tell you what's wrong with you sick-wise. So yes, really interesting. As a physician, we are very much trained on physical exam, and your tongue gives us a little entry point in some of the things that could be going on with your body. If you have a pale tongue, that could lead us down the road of the fact that you might have anemia. Or if you have a bright red strawberry-looking tongue, it could be a sign of a vitamin deficiency or something called Kawasaki's disease. I was today years old when I realized blood is blue. In an octopus, that is, and they have three hearts. So cool. Okay, people tell me all the time that blood is blue and I lose my mind because blood is not blue, blood is red. But in an octopus, it actually is blue, and that's because they have a copper-based blood product and it's called hemocyanin, which makes the color blue of your blood. But what's so cool about the hearts is they have three hearts. Two of the hearts pump blood to the gills. The third pumps blood to the rest of the body. I hope you guys learned something. This was a lot of fun. These are a lot of interesting statements that came across my way. If you have more statements, questions, concerns, let me know in the comments. And as always, do me a favor, definitely check out this playlist right here, binge watch everything, and make sure you subscribe, turn on your bell notifications, and hit that like button for me. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.